the rat!
Hey guys, what's going on? Look at what I got. Check it out. I'm excited, super excited. I've got all new components. I've got the Goblin RAW 500. I'm ready to see what this 6S can put out and how it can handle all the maneuvers. It's been a while since I had a 6S, so flying the 6S bird will, you know, open up windows for other birds that are 6S that I could just pop one battery in and get multiple flights instead of always flying 12S packs. So I'm going to open up this really quick, probably show you what's inside, and then after that, I'll build it, and I'll show you the key points and all the new innovative creations, and then after that, we'll put it in the air, we'll test it, we'll see how it runs, and you'll hear me when I talk about it. That'll be funny how I react when I'm flying and I feel it. So we'll go from there. All right, guys, see you soon. Wow, let's do it. Let's open this box and let's see what's inside. I'm excited. I saw one at Heli X while I was there. I really didn't get to see the flights, but I did see one on the table. It was beautiful. So as always, here we are. Perfect manual. Look at that. And I love that they always put like the upgrades and spare parts in the back, because you can just get right in here and figure out what you like or what you don't like or what you want to upgrade and swap it out. So this is awesome. Look at that. Smells good too. All right. You know about the registration card and the online SAB followers. All right. Get some space here. All right. I just want to see the canopy and then I'll leave you guys alone until I build it. Let's see what this is like here. You know what everything else looks like. It's all boxed up and pretty. Nice hard foam to protect everything. All right, let's see. This is what I want to see here. It's my favorite part. Oh yeah, look at that. Wow. It's so small. This is gonna be fun. Look at that. Wow. Maybe we should open this as well. Okay. Oh yeah, wow, some matte finish, look at that. Wow, it's beautiful. Well, I can't wait. We got a couple other pieces here. You got some side frames, upper frames, landing gear, and then you already know the rest is there. So we'll get to building and we'll be back. Man, look at that. Look how simple this is. It's so simplified. I can't wait. I want to see what it's going to look like in the end, you know. But look how simplified this is. You got your tail belt pulley here. Your main gear here. I'm assuming the motor's going to fit up here. It's all assumptions. This is the rear. It's also assumption from what it's looking like. Oh, look. This is probably the rear here. We'll figure it out. Well, check out these servos. This is the BLS 1809M, right? They're so sleek, nice and clean. And I love the fact that it comes with all these servo horns. Check this out. Even though I may not use them, I might use a SAB Mini servo horns. But it's still nice to have all these options. I've never seen any servo brands send you three different sets, which is kind of cool if you think about it. So that's awesome. Check this out here. It's a new type of battery latch here. I've never seen that before, but it's got like a little pin. And you rotate it here. And it pulls it all the way in. Look at that. If you can see that. You can pop it right out. Yep, look at that. That's cool. And then the canopy mount here. That's where I'm assuming it attaches, because it says it here in the manual. Canopy base. And this is a new type of quick release latch. It's kind of cool. It's a little different, man. A little different. Everything different makes it better. I'm sure they thought about it. I can't wait to see this complete. I'm working fast. As you can see, I got all the servos mounted with the horns, the balls, the knee already connected, and getting ready to move to the next step here, and we just go from there. Aha, look where we are now. This thing is looking sweet. Look at this. We got with the battery tray slides in, the new setup here. We got all kinds of things going on. New layout. This kind of reminds me of the Fireball layout. Fireball had a layout similar to this with servo stand up pretty straight. This is awesome here. I can't wait to get further. I'm sure the motor's gonna sit up here. Next steps with the head, but we're gonna get this thing done ASAP because I'm excited to get out there and throw this thing around. Check this out, guys. I found this interesting and different from any other SAB that I've built. I've built a good amount, a fair amount over the years. So on this one here, if you look at the servo links, they're all different sizes. Well, not them all, but the elevator is a different length when compared to the aileron servos here for the cyclic. Look at that. And they give you so many options because they say that the lack of standard with mini servos, the distance between the top of the servo and the center of the servo spline is how you measure and figure out what link you're going to use. So they send you different links for the ailerons here, right? And I'm going to show you. I've used these here that come with it. It includes this fancy little tool here that you can use to adjust. But anyways, these are your other options here depending on your servo brand, right? You see that? This one's just straight threaded all the way through. This one has a little space in between the threads. But I found that cool. That was a little different from any other build. But look at the layout. It's beautiful. Torque servos. Yes, sir. Oh, this is going to be really fun. I'm still excited. From the start to the finish, the building and the maiden. Maiden's my favorite part. And the feel. So I'm going to keep moving. And if I run into anything else pretty cool, I'll get right back to you guys. All right, guys, here we go. Check this out. Look at this. Anyone ever see that before? It's my first time seeing it. And I kind of like the idea that they added this bearing here to offset the belt and keep it tight on the pulley. And so it actually allows more of the belt to grab the pulley, right? Because it comes up here and grabs back here and it won't just fall off over here because that gear is so wide. It'll push the belt in and it'll grab from probably about 7 o'clock to 3 o'clock instead of 9 to 3 or something like that, or even less. It probably could be 10 to 2, but that's pretty cool. So here's the belt. That's my next step. I've got everything all hooked up here. Landing gear, servos, see my dangling flyballless unit. And I'm gonna keep pushing till we get this thing airborne. And I'm ready. I'm still ready. I'm still ready to see what it's gonna do in the air, man. I'm still ready. All right, so check this one out. I like this one. Check this out. If you look here, you've probably seen videos, but now it's in front of me. It's a little different. But imagine taking all the guesswork out of how tight your belt should be. You know how many times I've been to the field and I'm about to fly and somebody's like, oh, your belt feels tight or your belt's loose. Now, this eliminates everything. They've done all the work to figure out what is the right tension. And you see, there's numbers here. Probably can't really see it on the camera. But it goes as follows. It goes from 0, and then it has positive 1, positive 2, and then negative 1, negative 2. So you would like to have that sitting right there at the 0. And at the 0 means you've got the right tension. No more guesswork. Simple. I think that's awesome. What do you guys think of this new quick release battery tray? That's what I'm working on here. I remember they came out with this for the 380 back in the way back. And now they've got it here. I'm curious to see how helpful and useful it is. So let's see. I think it looks pretty good though. I got this. I've soldered them nice and clean, heat shrink them. And then I have the two halves, snap them in. If you look here, there's a negative and a positive. So you can't miss it. All right, guys, so check it real quick. This is the battery setup here. We're gonna do the quick release battery tray. Everything's mounted up nice and neat. As you can see here, it's screwed on here with two plastics. There's a split system where there's a top and bottom portion of this connector. So you set that with this screw here to keep it intact. So it's real simple. So for example, I want to go fly. I'm just going to pop the battery in through the rear here. But first, I'll leave this latch where it says closed, right? And then I'll just slide it right in through the rear here. And once I push this all the way forward, the latch is going to actually close on its own. You see that? And you hear the helicopter activate. So it's ready to fly there. Just got to leave it sitting. Obviously, I would have to have my controller on. I don't at the moment. I just wanted to show you before I take it out to the field. All right, guys. Quick release right here. And then we just pop it right out the rear. Push, pull. Battery's out. Helicopter's off. Easy, 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 easy. All right, guys. Check it out. She's ready to rock and roll with the maiden. I'm still super excited. I can't wait to get out there and start tumbling and rolling and climbing out and check this thing out, man. It's just beautiful. This is a complete different build from any other SAB I've built. I know that this latch is similar to the 420, but I've never built one or flown one. So this is all new to me, the entire setup. All right, I'm going to head to the field. I'll be back. All right, guys, we made it to the local park. And we're going to put a flight down, test it out, see what it feels like. We're going to go over it a little bit and hopefully everything feels great like every other SAB. So go check it out. I got my nice Mineo there, my torque servos, 120 amp, hobby wing. I've got the new HK5 motor, 850 kV. And I'm running a little different blades just because I like the feel of bigger blades. All right, let's get it. All right, let's see what this is all about. We're gonna start off with bank one. Oh man, it feels great so far. Look at that. Super locked in, Anchorman. Wow. That right there is 2400 RPM. Battery, long flight on that battery, 3700 pulse. All right, let's see a little, crank it up a little bit. Now we're at 27, almost 28. This is all stock. Stock setup, I haven't tweaked it to how I like it. It actually feels pretty good so far. Crank them up one more time, then we'll land, then we'll check everything. Now we're at 32, almost 32. We got a tail wag. That's a high head speed with the tail. I haven't adjusted yet. So we'll bring it back down. And then we'll tweak it and we'll fly some more and see how it does, you know. Right now it feels awesome, especially with a stick though. I can't believe it. What are you thinking, man? Alright guys, so I got about 6 flights down so far. The maiden was great, even with the stock settings. After that I flew it a couple more times, probably about 6 times, and I did a little tweaking to my liking for my flying style. Even though it was good, I just like it a little faster on the faster side. So I tweaked it a little bit to see what I can get out of the model itself. And as far as I can tell, this thing is killing it, man. I'm already gonna order a second battery, another Pulse 3770C. Came down nice and warm, not hot. So the C rating is doing good with this model. I like the quick release battery tray. I really do, because you just pop the pack in, right in the back, connect and go. When you finish, you pull it out, you're good to go. But if you do buy the model and you decide to purchase more than one battery, there's only one battery tray included with the quick connect, and there's nothing included for you to charge it. So if you were gonna buy it and you wanted to use a quick connect, I would actually get on the site once you put the model in the cart, and I would add another one of these connectors here. They sell them separate for about $9 on Heli Direct. So if you buy this here, you can create a charging connection to, for your charger. That way you can charge them, because if you just solder everything up and you don't have a way to charge them, you're stuck. So that's what I did. I went and I ordered an extra connector here, and I created my own charging port. So I charge them pretty quick. Other than that, I guess if I would buy this again, definitely. My son might want one. We might have to have the matching pair. Why not? It's a great machine, like every other Saab. You know where to find them. Head to Heli Direct. It's already on the top there. I think they're in stock. You don't have to pre-order. Grab yours, set it up. Message me on the bottom and let me know what you think. I love it, and I'm gonna keep flying it. I'm actually gonna fly it right now. So I'm gonna put another flight on it, and I'm gonna keep letting it rip. So y'all have fun and be safe out there. Thanks.
Heli Direct!